Hello students, today I have made some new changes in my channel and I am learning the YouTube, so I hope you will notice my changes which I have done in my channel and today's video. Do like and share so you can get the notification whenever I will upload my next video. Now today we are going to understand the various type of motors, small motors actually, which we call fractional horsepower motors, FHP motors. Now let's start with the basic concept. So actually fractional horsepower motor is which having capacity of less than 1 kW, 1 HP, sorry, 1 HP. So these are motors are basically single phase motors which we use in different small appliances. So one by one we will understand what are they and how we can apply or use them in various appliances. So in first we can say the fractional horsepower motor will begin with single phase induction motor. Single phase induction motor. It is most convenient to use single phase AC motor instead of DC motors, as we know, because we have our radio of AC phase everywhere. But if you want to use a DC motor, then we have to make a separate arrangement for that. So we basically prefer AC motors over DC motors. Why? Because it's availability, the supply availability. We know that supply is available in AC, in our residential, commercial or industrial, any purpose we know that AC is available easily, but DC is not available that much easily. We have to make separate arrangement, and rather than making separate arrangement, we can use a motor which can be run on AC. So this is the concept why we use fractional horsepower motor as an AC motor. Now you will understand the construction of single phase AC induction motor. A single phase induction motor has two main, namely part, stator and rotor. Basically every motor have these two parts. One is stator, another one is rotor. Rotor means which is rotate, stator means it is a stationary, keep always standstill. Okay, the stator winding is connected across single phase AC supply. The AC supply produces a rotating magnetic field in air gap between the stator and rotor. The field rotates at a speed called synchronous speed in the stator side. Okay, because stator get directly supply, and whatever flux it produces, it is based on the actual supply, actual frequency. There is no losses because stator is stationary. That's why we call this NS as a synchronous speed. That means we can never cross this synchronous speed, because this speed is produced because of our frequency which comes with the supply. Second thing, the induction motor actually rotates at the speed at which is slightly less than synchronous speed. Why it rotates less than synchronous speed, I will tell you later. Now we will see the diagram which have the rotor of copper and aluminium bars, or aluminium bars permanently short circuited on the both end. So this is the construction of squirrel cage rotor. Okay, this is the rotor side in which you can see the bar type, different bars are fixed in a circular way, and you can observe this structure as a cage. That's why we call it as squirrel cage. Okay, and this is the front view of our squirrel cage induction motor. These are the bars which start from one end and go till to another end, and they all are shorted with the common ring which we call end ring. means we short them all, you know, both ends we will short it, and this way we can create a squirrel cage rotor. Now what is exactly split phase induction motor? I will tell you that if we know that on a just single half cycle we can't complete 360 degree, as half cycle is only 180 degree. So we know that if I will take a one half cycle, then I will never, it is not possible to complete one full rotation of a rotor. That means my motor will never going to run. For that purpose we have to split our phases, means we will take a single input and then we will split it into two ways, and then our motor can possibly run. We will understand this in working principle, but here in this diagram you can observe that this is our main winding, and same time we have connected one another winding which is called as start winding or auxiliary winding. And here is centrifugal switch. Centrifugal switch means which a switch which act with the centrifugal forces. That means whenever the motor will start, after starting the switch will act and it will act as an open circuit, and once the motor will run, it will run only with one winding, which is main winding. Okay, keep this in mind. We will discuss this in detail after, but here keep this in mind. We need two phases to start the motor to complete 360 degree, as our half cycle is having 180 degree. That's why I need at least two half cycles, and which I can get from minimum two phases. Now one winding, main winding is always fixed, second winding is auxiliary winding or starting winding, which is connected with a centrifugal switch. Whenever at the starting the switch is closed, and when the motor get rotation because of this the flux produced in this winding and this winding, means we have two different flux at different degree. That means I have now two half cycles which can rotate my rotor, and once possibly it get rotated, the centrifugal forces will act on the switch, and switch will be act as an open circuit, and this winding will automatically get isolated from the circuit, and then in running condition my motor will run on only main winding and rotor. Okay, I hope you understand this concept. Principle of operation. I have already discussed that I need minimum two phases. So a single phase AC supply is connected to a stator winding. The forces an alternating current through the stator winding. This current produces an alternating flux in the gap between stator and rotor. So here is first step. When I will provide the supply, this is my stator winding, this one and this one, which will create flux here. Flux, as we know that every current carrying conductor create flux, and if this is winding, that means a very high density of flux can be produced here. This flux will produce in primary or stator winding. Okay, secondly, the alternating flux passes over the rotor conductor and induced an EMF into it due to transformer action. Now see, when the flux will create here, it is rotating flux because we are running this motor on AC phase. That means this flux is a rotating flux, so it will cut the conductors of this rotors. It will cut the conductor of this rotor, and we know that in transformer principle we know that when flux cut the conductor, or according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, or flux cut the conductor, or conductor cut the flux, and EMF will induce it. So our second stage is rotor get induced EMF inside. Now due to induced voltage, a current start flowing through the rotor conductor. This current will then produce its own flux called rotor flux. Now see, here once the flux gets induced here, we know that if the current will start flowing through these bars, then definitely it will create its own flux. Okay, so this flux will be created in rotor, and the flux created in rotor we can call it as a rotor flux. Okay, so the main flux produced by the stator winding interact with the rotor flux to produce the torque. The rotor flux get produced due to principle of induction. Why the rotor flux get flux? Because according to Faraday's law, when the main flux or stator flux cut the conductor of rotor flux, it will get EMF induction, and EMF create, or when the current flow, it will create flux around it. So basically we may have now a rotor flux which interact with the stator flux, and our motor will start. Just keep this mind that rotor interacts with the rotor flux to produce the torque. Torque means here rotation. Okay, torque means rotation. The rotor flux get produced due to principle of induction, hence it is called as induction motor. Okay, so I hope you understand now why we call single phase induction motor. The motor which run on induction principle is called as induction motor. But single phase induction motor are not self starting like DC. The reason behind that I have already discussed, that I need a complete cycle to complete one rotation, and for that purpose I need minimum 2.5 cycles to complete one 360 degree. And for that purpose, here we can say a single phase induction motor are not self starting like DC motor. Now to get it started, I have to split the phases, that I have already told you. But how can that possible? So here are some methods used to make an induction motor self-starting. Based on these techniques, the single phase induction motor are classified as follows: split phase induction motor, capacitor start induction motor, capacitor start, capacitor run induction motor, shaded pole induction motor. Okay, so these are the four types of single phase induction motor. Now first is split phase induction motor. Split phase induction motor we can also call as resistive split phase induction motor. The construction I will show you in next slide. This motor consists of two winding, namely the main winding and auxiliary starting winding, which are displaced from each other by an angle of 90 degrees. The main winding is highly inductive while starting winding is resistive. So main winding is highly inductive, keep this in mind, highly inductive, starting winding is resistive. We know that lagging and leading, you know, phase differences, we understand that if the inductors there is lagging, if a resistance there is in phase value of our current and voltage. So here I can make two phases through the one phase by adding inductor in one phase, connection, and by adding resistance in another connection. So here it is, you can understand betterly here. See, whenever I will do the supply, I will connect one main winding. See, every winding have its self resistance and self inductance. Here I show it separately to get better understanding. So I have main winding and auxiliary winding. One having high resistance means RA, which we I can add more resistance here, and here I will concentrate on more inductive material. Means like copper, here I can use some resistive material to get the current absorbed more in this auxiliary winding, because it is for temporary purpose. So losses are not that much important here. So how it exactly work? See, this is IM current which is flowing from main winding, which is because of the inductor which lags the voltage by approximately 90 degree. Okay, that we know that. Okay, second current is IA. We can say this current is flow from starting winding, so I can say I can call it as IST. It is a starting winding. This same current IA, but it is with the higher resistance at a which is faced in a starting winding. So IST is having resistive phenomena. That's why we know that it try to keep in phase with voltage. So a very small lagging with the voltage, and we know that both current are create our resultant current, which is I, which is tell our motor to run. And by adding these two phases, I have get a I main current, which will tell our motor to run. Basically, from this diagram, you can understand we always connect one end of our winding here and another one end of exactly opposite to the winding. So one end will act as a N pole, another terminal will act as a S pole. That's why we made this type of arrangement. Principle of operation. The current flowing through the main winding IM lags behind the voltage V. I have already explained this on a diagram. So we will continuously reading this. V by 90, since the main winding is highly inductive, the current flowing through the starting winding IST is almost in phase with the supply voltage V. This winding is resistive. The flux produced due to the current will be placed 90 degree with respect to each other, and resultant of the flux will be a rotating magnetic field due to RMF, rotating magnetic field. A non-zero starting torque acting in one direction will be produced. The centrifugal switch connected in a series with starting winding gets automatically open circuited when the motor speed reaches about 70-80% of synchronous speed. Here the gravitational force will be, or centrifugal force will act on that switch, which we know that, and then it will open after the motor rotates only on the main winding. Thus, under the running condition, the auxiliary winding remain out of the circuit. How can I reverse this motor? The direction of rotating of split phase motor can be reversed by reversing the terminal of either main winding or starting winding. The direction of rotation change due to reversal in direction of rotating magnetic field. So I just have to change the direction of any one winding, either main winding or either auxiliary winding. I can change the rotation of motor. Means suppose at start, if our motor is running in an anti-clockwise direction, if I will change the direction of main winding or auxiliary winding connections, then it will run in an anti-clockwise or clockwise. Application. The starting torque of this motor is poor, so it is used in following applications: fan and blowers, washing machine, centrifugal pumps. Now I have one task for you. Give me the answer why this motor having low starting torque. Give the answer in your comment box, and I will appreciate if you I will get the correct answer. Thank you very much.